Now, George, you here? Glenn, you here? Everybody here? Thunderbirds here? We're ready to roll here. Ladies and gentlemen, would you give the number one gospel group of the country a good welcome this evening? The Cathedral Quartet.
I tell you, we have enjoyed ourselves so far this evening sitting out here. I could have left a moment ago, when this trio from Canada got through singing and went home praising the Lord. Enjoyed you folks so much. And I really did. Didn't you enjoy these folks? Yeah, great. Just one thing I want to say to the piano player, don't you ever try singing that bass again. And then Dave and the ensemble, I thought they sung beautifully. And then this crazy little man that came out here a while ago. Gary McSpadden brought that song to us, The Plan of Salvation, a few months ago. And I do want to say, just stop and pause a moment and say, Lord, I do thank you for the plan of salvation.
Amen.
I love those words. It's a good song. I love my verse, and I love to hear me sing. Give me that key again.
One morning at daybreak, a crowd slowly gathered. They were walking my Lord up old Calvary's hill. Listen now. So sad was the scene. Birds hush their singing, like a lamb he was humble to his father's own will. I want to thank Jesus for the plan of salvation. Just to say, Lord,
we love you tonight.
For you understand.
I want to be there.
I want to be there. On that great judgment morning. To touch God. Jesus is a master builder. make a friend of you. And he can make a friend of you. Jesus is a master builder.
Mark. The young man singing that song, Mark Trammell is his name. He's from North Little Rock, Arkansas. You glad to see Mark? Yeah. Do you know what I'm going to do? I was going to wait a moment. You're looking at the cathedral tonight, and you're seeing a new face for the
and
first
several
time.
Several old faces.
And one head that looks like it's wore out three or four bodies right here. But I want to do something. I was going to wait a while and sing about five or six songs, and then I was going to introduce this young man to. But let me do it right now. I just feel impressed to. Roger Bennett, our former piano player. Roger, after his second child came along, Roger felt like he needed to spend more time with his family, and the Lord opened a door for Roger to do that, and we're so thankful to God that he did. And then the Lord opened a door for us with a young man. You know what? God makes no mistakes. We're happy for Roger because he wanted to be at home with his family, and God opened that door for him. And then the Lord also sent us a young man that we believe with all of our hearts that this young man is here tonight because God sent him our way. His name is Gerald Wolfe, and he's from Morristown, Tennessee. He's 23. You know what? Gerald's 23 years old. I was thinking about it. Gerald's 23, Mark's 27, Danny's 32, and Glenn, all of their ages don't add up to yours. I'll get back to him in a minute.
Way over 80, Glenn.
You know what I want to do? I want to do something. Gerald flew to Atlanta and to rehearse with us while we were at the Joyful Noise there. And after Gerald walked in, we heard him play and sing the first song. We did not look any further because we knew God had sent the young man to us. I want you to listen to this young man. Not only is he a fabulous piano player, but I want you boys run over that song down to Joyful Noise, the Land of Living. And I want you to listen as Gerald Wolfe and the boys sing Land of Living.
Where living is forever,
about Gerald Wolfe? Would you welcome him to Detroit, Michigan tonight? Yes, sir. Yeah, I tell you what, son, I love that song. Yeah.
Gerald, I tell you what, why don't you say a word to us, Gerald, and sing that? I tell you what, I'm about to, excuse me just a moment. Well, glory. Yeah. When you got one of them in you, you better let it out or it'll hurt you.
You better, I'll tell you.
Say a word for us and sing that verse again.
It's so nice to be here on my second week with the Cathedral Quartet. And this week I've been at home and I've been by myself. My wife's not in Stowe yet. And it's been kind of lonely. And the George and Glenn have tried to keep me from getting lonely. And Mark called me on the phone. And everybody's been trying to keep from getting lonely. And I kind of miss my wife and sitting around the house there with nothing to do by myself. And I begin to think, and I put on a tape that we did last Sunday night at the Cathedral Tomorrow, and we begin to listen to that tape and how the Lord blessed in that service.
Yes.
And I realized that I was not alone sitting in my apartment, but there was someone there with me who sticks closer than a brother.
Amen.
I've got two brothers at home, and they love me, and they do anything for me, but there's no one who can do for me what Jesus did for me so many years ago when I was 8 years old, when he saved my soul and made me fit to go to the land of living. I'm still not a good person by any means, but I know the Lord, and I've trusted him with all my heart and life, and he's able to keep that I've committed to him against that day. You listen to the second verse. The sun is nothing but a legend in this paradise of dreams.
I feel another glory coming on.
Go ahead.
That shouting ground.
You know what? The Lord makes no mistakes.
Amen.
And Glenn and I are so proud of these young men that God has sent our way to help us carry on our ministry. 42 years for Glenn, 40 years for me, singing full-time gospel. And you know what? Glenn and I were talking about it the other day. Think about this. After all those years, we are enjoying ourselves right now more than we ever have in our life. Not because of what we are doing, but because of what God is doing.
I tell you one thing, I like to hear us sing.
Yeah. We'd just as soon hear us sing as anybody we've ever heard, in other words. You know what? A few years ago, we've been coming here for I don't know how many years to this.
1903, I think.
But one of the first times we ever came here, somebody hollered out of the audience and wanted us to do what we're about to do. I guess we're on the quartet now that's still doing this type of thing. He wanted us to sing the notes instead of the words. Glenn and I went to Stance Baxter School of Music in Dallas, Texas to learn how to read the shape notes.
It's hard to do.
Well, it's easy if you got the book, but it's hard to do. Let's do a verse in the chorus of Oh Happy Day.
And this may not be a happy day.
Everybody do the do re mi's to your part. Now, everybody goes every which way, so don't sing the words. Do the notes. So do re mi.
So mi la so.
So do re mi.
So mi la so.
Mi fa re re.
Fa 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 fa.
So mi
re do.
So do re mi.
So mi la so.
So do re mi.
So mi la so.
Mi fa re re.
Fa 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 fa.
So mi re do.
Fa fa fa.
So 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 re.
So
re.
So la so.
Do do ti ti.
So, so, so,
mi,
re, re,
so, so,
do,
do, do,
so,
do,
so,
do, do, do,
do,
so,
la,
so,
do, so,
so,
mi,
do,
so, la, so, mi,
do, do, ti,
do, do, mi, re, do,
do, do,
do, do.
Do that candy, coody, woody, candy, candy.
Questions and doubts, I tried to figure it out, but the best that I could do was wander around in the love that I found until my questions started answering themselves, singing, candy, coody, woody, yes, candy, coody, woody,
day.
Candy,
candy,
singing,
coody,
woody,
woody,
candy, coody,
woody,
candy,
coody,
woody,
yes, candy, coody,
woody,
day.
You could say you don't know necessarily so, like somebody said it once in a song.
You can think what you choose, but let me tell you the news. The Lord has loved you all along.
So if you're asking again, well, the dust of her incense, be just a man to see for yourself. Singing, candy, goody, woody, yes, you can, goody, woody, day.
Oh, candy,
singing,
goody,
woody, woody,
day.
Let me tell you what my Savior did.
There was a little girl asked for the same song that you asked for a moment ago about the choo-choo song, except she said, sing that song where all of you sneeze.
Sneeze?
And I said, honey, I don't believe I know what you're doing. She said, well, all of you say, a-choo, a-choo, a-choo. Let's do that. And by the way, we are coming back to Canada. When we are?
In April, we're coming to London, Ontario.
Yeah, okay. We'll
first be time in a long time.
First time in a long time. So do that choo-choo song.
Don't you hear that choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-
Coming back, oh, listen, we'll, we'll, we'll. you get to heaven, you must get off that train.
For that's the glory special, takes you through the pearly gate. Oh, get on board for the glory, all aboard.
All aboard this train for glory.
Don't you hear the choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-
the conductor's call.
Don't you hear the choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-
got my ticket in my hand. For that's a glory special, takes you to the promised land. Oh, get aboard, all the glory, all aboard, all aboard for glory lands.
Hear that whistle blow and hear it coming down the track.
Better get your tickets in.
It's not coming back, oh listen.
Oh brother, if you get to heaven, you must get
off that train.
For that's the glory special, takes you through the pearly gate. Oh, get aboard, oh, the glory, all aboard.
Aboard this train for glory.
If I was a tenor singer, I'd want to sing just like that little pipsqueak right over there. This soon be 41 years for me, and Danny Funderburk is the most powerful tenor to ever come along in our field, I feel. And we're proud of Danny. We're proud of Danny. The last 2 years in a row in Nashville, Tennessee, he's been voted the favorite tenor singer all across the country, and there's no doubt in my mind that he's just that, and God has blessed him with a powerful voice. I want you to listen. Danny thrills me with this song because one day the Master touched my life. One day I came to Jesus, a broken, ruined man. I asked him to forgive me. I confessed my sins and invited him to my heart. And I claim the word of God tonight that when I did that, he said he blotted my yesterdays out, never to be remembered again. I remember those days, but I claim the word of God tonight that said he would remember them no more.
No more.
Right. He touched me, and I've never been the same since the touch of the Master's hand.
Amen.
I've shared this with you every year, and I started not to. The Lord just spoke to my heart right then. 1950, I joined the paratroopers, the 82nd Airborne Division, bunked beside a little boy called Mousy Gonzalez. Mousy introduced me to marijuana. 1950, 51, 52, 53. Way back then, I was smoking them left-handed cigarettes. Thought I was the toughest thing in Fort Bragg. A little later on, wound up in the gutter nearly because of the bottle. And when I say a broken, ruined man, I came to Jesus. I was broken and I was ruined.
Yeah, listen.
Listen to this song. Somebody touch me.
Many years he walked in darkness as he groped along the streets with his hands stretched out. Just a bite to eat. It's the story of the blind man who met Jesus on his way, and with the Master's touch, the man looked up as the scoffers heard him say,
somebody touched me, somebody.
Again. Enough to get excited about.
That's all right.
George, can I say something?
Oh,
I think we've got plenty of time. And I just want to say what Jesus Christ means to me.
Yes.
1986 was a very good year for me and my family. Well, 3 years ago, let me start back 3 years ago. I just feel like sharing this with you. I joined the Cathedrals in Christmas of 83. I remember when I went sliding in Ohio, there was ice and snow everywhere. And I was looking for Mark's house, and I did. I literally slid by the driveway, and I said, "Lord, is this really where you want me to go?" He said, "No, I want you to back up and turn to Mark's driveway." Because I passed it. I was doing about 80, you know. But God has blessed me and my family because I know I'm where God wants me to be.
Yeah, I believe it.
And George and Glenn, all they've done in the last 3 years is just brag on us young guys. And I want to brag on them just a little bit. You know, without a doubt, that George Yance and Glenn Payne are dedicated to the Lord. to sing gospel music as long as they have for 40 years and 41 years, and they still stand true to the Lord and His will and what He has for them to do with their lives. It just amazes me to see Glenn and George be able to stand up here as old as they are and get excited and sing. It knocks me out. They wear us young guys out, believe me. So I know God's got their hand on their life. And I was thinking about it today when we were sharing at the dinner table how God has richly blessed our family in the last 3 years.
That's right.
It's all because I feel like I'm in the center of God's will.
Yeah, I believe it, Danny.
And I just can't wait for 87 to start because God has got so much in store for the Cathedral Quartet. And I'm excited about it. I think we as Christian people ought to be excited about our salvation, get excited about what Jesus Christ has done for us in our lives.
Come on.
And quit complaining and grumbling. And I'm the world's worst to be the first to complain and grumble about anything. But I want to stand here tonight and make a confession to you. With the help of the Lord, 1987, I'm going to lift His name up the best I know how. In truth and in song. And I'm not going to grumble like I used to. Because I ain't found anybody that will stand still long enough and let me complain to them. But I'm serious.
Yeah.
We need to get excited about it whom Amen. We serve. In 87, this could be the last year that we have to proclaim the gospel in song. And to tell people about Jesus. Because He's coming back soon. And I just had to share that with you. I'm just excited about 87 fixing to take place, and I'm looking for a great year in the Lord. Thank you.
I believe you enjoy Danny Thunderbird.
Danny, bless your heart, buddy.
I love you too, buddy. You know, since we got here tonight, I felt the presence of the Lord. I enjoyed this trio from Canada, Simcoe, you said, right? I enjoyed them tonight. They ministered to me, and I really appreciate that. And I felt His presence all night long. You know, we who know the Lord Jesus Christ, there is joy in serving the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, we've laughed, we've cried, but we've got a right to. We're the only people in the world who have a right to be happy and have a good time. And I felt His presence. We don't do this song too often, but when it comes to singing a song like this, the old man here, it thrills me to see an 87-year-old man.
I know. I know that was coming sooner or later.
I just can't stay too straight too long, Glenn. You know. No, I mean, after 42 years, he can take a song like this and magnify the name of Jesus better than anybody I've ever heard. Do that into His presence. That so many people asked for that we recorded a few years ago, and everywhere we go, this is a must. We try not to sing this song sometimes, and people throw things at us if we don't, you know. Called Moving Up to Glory Land.
I like to think about paradise somewhere beyond the blue. I mentioned where sky, maybe next door,
maybe next door to you.
We'll go forever through the distant stars,
right in the Milky Way.
The plan is to
the plan is to the turn left you and Mars.
Won't even be
to glory land.
Budwash Band there.
We're a band of Christian soldiers fighting Satan every day. We're standing up for Jesus while we're kneeling down to pray. If his precious blood has cleansed you and washed away your sins, that makes you a member of the Blood-Washed Band. Praise God, I'm a member of the Blood-Washed Band. I've been washed in the salt and the blood of the Lamb. I was bound by chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the Blood-Washed Band.
God's children are advancing, marching till we reach the goal. For the battle's almost over, we'll soon be going home. I can hear the sound of angels as the saints go marching in, singing praises to the captain of the Blood-Washed Band.
Praise God, I'm a member of the Blood-Washed Band. I'm in washed in the salt, cleansing blood. Change of sin. Till one day the Master came and made me a member of the Blood-Washed Band.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
God's children are advancing, marching till we reach the goal. For the battle's almost over, we'll soon be going home. I can hear the sound of angels as the saints go marching in, singing praises to the captain of the Blood-Washed Band.
Praise God, I'm a member of the Blood-Washed Band. I've been washed in the salt springs of blood of the Lamb.
I was bound by chains of sin.
That's a good song.
You know, we weren't here to sing you a Christmas carol, and I know that after Christmas maybe you don't want to hear a Christmas song, but we let me do something for you. We recorded an a cappella Christmas album year before last. It turned out to be the most fabulous thing we think that we've ever done because of all the hard work that went into doing a cappella Christmas song. Could we sing you a Christmas song? Come down here, boys. Gerald, give us the key to God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day. To save the world from Satan's power when we had gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
From God that is our Father, the blessed angel came.
Unto some certain shepherds with tidings of the same, that there was born in Bethlehem the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. In Bethlehem,
in Bethlehem of Judah, the blessed babe was born. And lay within a manger this morn,
to which his mother Mary did nothing take in scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
bless your heart. You're magnificent. You are a joy to sing to. You know what? Let me do something here. I'm going to put Gerald on the spot again. Gerald met with us in Atlanta. We rehearsed a couple of days. Then he went home. We went on vacation. It was 19 days before we'd seen him again. This is his fourth concert with us. So we told Gerald to take our new traveling live album home with you, and listen. Yeah, and listen to him. And listen to him. And these young men here sang that song a moment ago, "Land of Living," bless my heart. Gerald, do you know the words to that homeland on it? I don't care if you don't. Make them up if you don't. Do that homeland. I want Gerald to say another word for us and sing that verse again. You know what? I'm glad tonight to know that it's well with my soul.
Amen.
That I got my house all in order and I'm packed and ready to go, should he call me tonight. Oh, I got a homeland over there, and Gerald gets me excited about going.
I tell you, a while ago I started to tell you about my salvation experience at the age of 8 years old. I was sitting about halfway back in the church one Wednesday night, and there were some people talking to my brother and counseling with him. He was older than I, and I was sitting there, and I was just kind of listening to what they were saying to him. And I began to think about my own life. At the age of 8, I thought, well, what if I died tonight? Would I be able to go to heaven? And I said to myself, no, I won't be able to go. And the Holy Spirit began to deal with my heart. And I got up and made my way to the altar. And Mom and Dad were there with me, and they had their hands on me, and they were praying, but you know, they couldn't save me. But Jesus came down, and he saved my soul, and he made me worthy to go to homeland. Not because I'm good, I'm not good. The Bible says there's none good.
That's right.
But Jesus was good,
yeah.
And his blood covered all my sins.
Hey.
It's amazing to think about the grace of God. When you stand and begin to think about the things that God can overlook, when you're covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, You don't get by with sin, understand, but Jesus paid the debt.
Yeah.
That you would not have to pay for those sins. The Bible says that God takes those sins and he casts them into the sea of forgetfulness, never to be remembered against you again. It's wonderful to know the love of the Lord Jesus Christ and to have experienced his grace in your life. And if you've not experienced that grace, and if you're not excited about serving the Lord tonight, this would be a good time. Even though it's New Year's Eve, you could go into a new year with a new life and live eternally with the Lord Jesus Christ. You beckon to my loved ones and how my tears did flow. And though I tried, I could not hide how it hurt to see them go.
But now ladies and gentlemen, the Cathedral Quartet.
So many of the kids were so mad at me during intermission. And this little boy sitting right down here, he threatened not to even speak to me. And one little girl come up and just looked at me and stomped on my toe.
Good,
no.
Good.
Well, you know what they were wanting. Give me a roll there, Gerald.
Oh, my name is Ticklish Reuben from way down in old Vermont. I've been tickled by almost everything. I've been tickled by a feather. I've been tickled by a wasp. I've been tickled by a yaller bumblebee.
Yeah, that's all, buddy. Oh. Oh, some of you had been looking at us like we was a bunch of nuts. I just thought I'd prove it before we left. You are a fabulous group. I just want to say thanks for all the wonderful comments during the intermission, all the beautiful words and the kind encouragement you gave us. And I want to say thanks for the wonderful words of encouragement and welcome that you gave Gerald here tonight. You know what? I know that this is his fourth concert with us, and he may be a little bit nervous. If he was, I sure couldn't tell it. But you made him feel loved here tonight, and I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Do you appreciate this young man? We don't usually do this, but somebody said, would you let him back up and sing his verse to Homeland one more time? You know, we don't usually repeat a song, but that song is powerful enough and good enough that I think it could stand repeating again. And I say again, I'm glad I got a homeland, and I'm looking forward. Gerald, do that verse one more time.
You beckon to my loved ones and how my tears did flow. And though I tried, I could not hide how it hurt to see them go. But now I know that they just left this world and moved to a better place. And someday soon you'll call me to and I'll see them face to face.
Well, in the city called
Homeland, I can hear you calling me, oh, my homeland, oh, how sweet it's gonna be.
we were asked to do so many songs tonight, and some more, a lot of them we haven't ever run over with Gerald, and I hate to put him on the spot, but there's one here that I promised somebody.
He can play it.
I guarantee he can play it.
If he can't, I can.
You just barely can walk and chew gum at the same time, Glenn.
That's very true. This is true.
I want you to listen as, and I know I shouldn't ask him to do this. We never have done Rivers of Joy with you, have we? Or did we? Well, I tell you what, just give us a, it's in the, what key is it? You know what, now I know
I'm flat and we get through with it, probably.
I know I'm putting him on the spot. We told him to take a G and How albums home, listen to them, and for him to remember all the keys, all the different songs, the styles, and then to put him on singing, and I think the young man is fabulous myself. I really do. Do that, Rivers of Joy. Oh, that's it. A scald on that thing. Woo! Gerald, that's great. You know, from that same album, there's a song that we did that Glenn done, the most powerful song I've ever heard Glenn sing. 22 years Glenn and I have been walking on stage together somewhere about the United States or Canada most every night for the last 22 years.
Amen.
We've been working together. God has blessed us, and in that time, I've heard Glenn sing a bajillion songs. This has to be the most powerful song I've ever heard him sing. We shall see Jesus.
We shall see Jesus. Just on a hill
as thousands were fed. And he touched the blind eyes. He healed broken spirits. He moved with compassion. Why, even raised up the did I.
The glory for great things he hath done. Oh, I don't know about y'all. We're in a Baptist church tonight, but I'm about to be Bablicostal or something. Oh, listen. I'm glad I'm saved. I'm glad I know beyond a shadow of a doubt tonight where I'm headed. And there's a lot of people all over these metro area celebrating. They're drinking. They're doing this and they're doing everything else, getting high. Well, I want to tell you something. I'm getting high on the Lord right now. I guarantee you that. If you're saved tonight, shout me a big amen.
Amen.
Oh, listen. It's the only real peace you'll ever find in this life. It's when you accept Jesus as Lord of your life and asking Him to come into your heart. Oh, listen. Behold, all things become new. You won't want to do the things you used to do. You, that crowd you used to run with, they won't like you no more. You walk in with that blessed book under your arm and you ain't going to have many friends right then. They're going to leave you. But I got news for you. Let your light shine that they might see Christ in your life. Amen? Let your light shine. Listen. He's coming back. You say, I don't believe it. It don't make no difference. He's coming back anyway. Better that you believe it. Better that you believe it. Oh, listen, I'm having a good time up here tonight. Got this new suit for Christmas, and it's got two pair of pants. And if I get any hotter, I'm going to have to take one of them off.
He's got both pairs. I love old people. I really do.
We and Christians don't have a right to have fun. We're the only ones that have a right to have fun. People are yelling and hollering and stomping and hollering and doing everything under the shining sun tonight. But if we get a little excited in church, a lot of folks call you a fanatic. I'm glad I'm a fanatic because I'm a fan of the Lord Jesus Christ. And these young people bless my heart tonight with their singing. Not only have they blessed my heart with singing, but look at them. They're clean cut. Beautiful young people. I think that's great. We live in a day and age. Boy, I'm telling you the truth. You can't tell which one is which. I'm going to tell you something. God is still on the throne. He's alive and well. Oh, listen. There's a song that keeps running through my mind. And I ain't got enough mind to worry about, so I'm going to go ahead and do it. George Yance. You know, he has a lot of nice things to say about me and these rest of these guys, but George Yance, beyond a shadow of a doubt, is the best bass singer I've ever heard. And that's just a fact. That's a fact. That's a fact. And I don't even know if you run over it or not, but there's a song that he sings, talks about the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm glad I didn't get justice when I came seeking for him.
Yeah, amen.
Oh, listen. I came seeking mercy. Oh, listen. This song blesses my heart. It's not a loud song. It's not a high song. But he takes this lead and sings it with so much heart. And I love it. It says, Jesus, have mercy on me.
Far from the best.
that awaits all the saints. But that's too high to hope to be. But when you look in the book and you're calling the roll, Jesus, have mercy on me. Lord, I'm down here where you used to be, but I failed all the tests that you passed, and so I won't be first in the race, but run it was all that you asked. When I stand before you on that final day, I'm sure that you'll plainly see it's not justice I'm needing, but mercy, oh Lord. Jesus, have mercy on me. Have mercy on one of your children who's failed and been far from the best, Lord. Jesus, have mercy on one who's unworthy and already overly blessed. Glory that awaits all the saints, but that's too high to hope to be. But when you look in the book and you're calling, Jesus, have mercy.
Thank the Lord for his mercy. Thank the Lord for his touch. Not long ago, we were in Muncie, Indiana, and Bill and Gloria Gaither came to spend the evening with us. We go there year after year, an evening with the Cathedrals, and Bill and Gloria are usually there. They sit on the front row. Glenn and I have known Bill and Gloria since they were kids.
We've known most people since they were kids.
And you ride again. But that night, I gave my testimony, as I did a moment ago, about the yesterdays of my life. And later, Gloria said, George, Bill and I have come to many concerts with you. But you touched my life in a special way tonight with your testimony. So we asked God to give us a song, especially for the Cathedrals. Bill and I asked God to give us a song, just especially for you boys. And that was quite a compliment, and that they would ask the Lord for a song, especially for us, two of the greatest songwriters to ever come along.
That's right.
We left, they left. A few weeks later, Bill called and said, you got to come by the house. We went by early one morning. Gloria had breakfast all fixed for us. You ought to go by there and eat sometime. Tell them the Cathedral sent you. But the Lord had given them the song that they had asked for us. and they couldn't wait to share it with us. I want you to listen. Glenn, I've never had a verse or song fit my life like the one that God gave Gloria, this verse for me. I want you to listen. This is unusual tonight. You know, I thought on stage when I come up here, we'd sing a bunch of up-tempo songs and maybe slow it down right to near the end of the service. Sing what we call two chords and a cloud of dust, most of them. But tonight the Lord has led in a special way, and I thank Him for His leading, and I thank Him for His guidance. I want you to listen to their latest effort at songwriting called Just an Old Sinner Saved by Grace.
If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I know you would see a miracle of love that took me in its sweet embrace and made me what I am today. Just an old sinner saved by
back with the lead.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm just
the Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah, just an old sinner, saved by grace. Thank the Lord. Thank you, Master. If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I know you would see the miracle of love that took me in its sweet embrace and made me what I am today. Just an old sinner saved by the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory.